this is Abhishek from Technic Media, and today we are here at the Samsung booth at Mobile World Congress 2013. And here we have the Samsung Galaxy Express with us. The Samsung Galaxy Express is a phone with 4.5 inch display, and it has WVGA resolution, the Super AMOLED Plus display basically. If we talk about the exact resolution of the display, it is 480 into 800 pixels. As you can see, this is a 480 into 800 pixel resolution at 4.5 inch display. It gives you a pixel density of around 207 pixels per inch, which is not very high, but it is again quite soothing in terms of the overall display. I really like the display of this device. It is quite soothing. In terms of the build quality and the form factor, the device is quite nice to hold in one hand. Although you have the back cover, which is glossy and plastic in nature, but it is again good quality of plastic which Samsung has used. And then you have a very stylish chrome lining across the edges of the phone, which makes the phone look quite premium. You have the volume rocker over here, which is a single button, and it is a button which gives you good amount of feedback as well. And then you have the home button over here, you have the soft key, the back key over here, and the property key over here. You have the front camera on this device. So the front camera on the device is 1.3 megapixel, which is capable of doing high definition video chat at 720p at 30 frames per second. Whereas if we talk about the back camera is 5 megapixel camera with LED flash, and the maximum resolution of photo which you can capture from this camera is 2592 into 1944. As far as the features are concerned, it has Wi-Fi 3G connectivity. It does support Wi-Fi Direct. You can also create a Wi-Fi hotspot as well on this device. If we talk about the in-built storage of the device, you have 8GB of in-built storage. Let me just show you how much of that is actually available to the user. So if we go under over here, if we go under storage options, so here we have the storage options. And as you can see, out of 8GB, around 4.56GB is actually available. And right now, around 3.01GB, to be very precise, is actually available to the user. If we talk about the RAM, this device has got 1GB of RAM. And if we take a look over the application manager over here, if I go into app manager and if I take a look at the current condition of the RAM, so as per right now, we are running multiple applications in the background, and 570 MB of RAM out of 1GB is actually used, whereas 238 MB is free, and which is actually making the phone quite sufficiently fast. Basically, there is no problem as far as the UI is concerned. I can go in between different applications, I can open applications, I can switch in between applications, I can access the multitasking by pressing the home button. Basically, it is again quite nice. So in terms of the overall performance of this device is quite nice, and it is another budget segment device from Samsung which is going to come in India, and it is going to be launched very soon. As far as the camera is concerned, let me just show you the camera UI. So if you go over here and if I launch the camera, so here we have the camera. The camera UI is again similar to the Samsung Galaxy Android devices which you have seen earlier. This is how the camera UI looks like. The camera UI is again inherited from the same nature UX UI which you see on other Samsung phones. And if I take a photo over here, and you do have tap to focus, and then it will take the photo. So if I show you these photos, this is how the photo looks like. It is quite okay in terms of the overall colors which you see. It is okay, there is no problem. The quality of the camera is again not very high. It is again quite average, but in terms of the overall color reproduction and the saturation of colors which I see in the photos, it is again quite nice. But because the device has got AMOLED Plus display, and if I test the overall viewing angles on the device are quite wide. Although if you view it at 170 or 160, the display will fade a bit, as well as the color will fade a bit, but the overall display is quite nice. And then you have quite wide viewing angles on this device because it's AMOLED Plus display, which is quite nice. Apart from this, if we talk about other specifications of the device, if I talk about the weight of this device weighs around 136 grams, which is fairly light, and it is announced recently and it is going to be available very soon in India. It does support LTE as well, but in other countries, the Indian model which will get launched, it will not support 4G as such. But and if we talk about other things, you have a 1.2 gigahertz dual core processor on this device. As well as the battery is concerned, the battery on the device is 200 milliampere hour battery, which should be sufficient for a display size of this size. But let's see, we will let you know during our review. That's all from us regarding the quick hands-on of Samsung Galaxy Express. Do let us know if you have any questions related to this device. We would love to help you. Please like this video if this video helped you, and subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.